Welcome back.
Oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny. She said ooh, ooh, shut up and dance with me. We were victims of the night.
Hello. And welcome to episode 23B of NewtSense. My name is Jan. You can find me as Jan Allen RN on pretty much everywhere. Ravelry, Instagram, Twitter. I have plucked a bit recently, but I'm pretty much Jan Allen RN every place. I'm calling this episode B because this is strictly going to be a haul video from SSK. And I know a lot of people either just don't want to sit through that, or I mean, I'm going to say right up front, I was kind of a bit of a pig. So, you know, I thought maybe I would just put this into a separate video so that if anybody didn't want to sit through it or wasn't interested in, you know, which I totally get. I mean, sometimes it could get a little overwhelming watching one of those. So I thought I would do it in a separate video. So that's what this is. I'm going to show you the goodies that I got at SSK. Just going to say that I went down with my daughter. We had a fabulous time. If you are interested in going, it is usually the second or third, it's a Wednesday to Sunday in July. I'm usually like the third week-ish. And signups usually go up around Labor Day. This past year, for this year's signup, went up a little bit late. I think it was actually almost November. End of October, November, when signups went up, and later, as you know, when we get closer, when I find out, and you find out from the watching the podcast, I will definitely share that information. And it's done by lottery, and so you put in your entry into the lottery. Like I said, it's in the past, it's been around a little bit after Labor Day. But last year it actually was a lot later than that. And then within a few weeks, they leave it open for a couple of weeks, and then you find out pretty quickly whether or not you got in or if you're put on the wait list. And the only thing I can say is that it's not the end of the world being on the wait list. I've gotten off it several times. And usually toward the end, as you get closer and closer to the event, people drop out for, you know, life happens, people drop out. And then they open up spots on the forum first to people that are on the wait list. So it's always a good thing to be, if you have any thought of going, get in the lottery, even if you're on the wait list. Usually when the spots open, they're always offered to people who are on the wait list first. So, you know, there's always a chance between, and usually come by the time the first payment is due, usually a few people will decide that they can't make it for whatever reason, so certain spots will open up. Then when the next payment is due, sometimes a lot of people say at that point. So there are points all throughout where they do pull from the wait list. And I know this year there were actually spots where the wait list had all been gone through and there were spots just opened up to people who had not even entered the lottery. And from what I think Laura had said, that some people got in actually literally the day before. So that's how it's done. I will keep you updated when the lottery is not one. Episode, not one episode, I haven't done anything yet, and I just dropped something on the floor, I guess. Okay, all right, let's just go with it. I'm a klutz, and that's all there is to that. Okay, all right, so what happens down there is most check-in is Wednesday afternoon. There's a big room where you all the knitters, there are a lot of tables and you get to go around and they give you a bingo card where you have to find a person who does a particular thing, whether it's they're a spinner, they're a crocheter, they've been there all the years, it's their first year, and you get people to sign it. Great icebreaker. So you get to go around, you get to meet new people, and you can swap your stitch markers, which if you watch the episode I just recorded, this was my first year in the stitch marker swap, and it was just beyond wonderful. I cannot believe how creative some people were. I thought I was had done such an amazing job with my easy-to-do stitch markers, and gosh, people just blew me away. But that's Wednesday night. They have opening ceremonies, which is always a treat. And door prizes, it's mind-boggling. There had to have been over, I'm going to just guess. I'm just going out a wild guess here, but I'm going to say there had to have been over 150 door prizes. There were that many. I mean, it was just unbelievable. And who the items that they got and whatnot. And I won. It was so funny because when Laura was, it's done by like I think they used to call it like a Chinese lottery or Chinese something where they used to use the cartons from Chinese takeout. And instead of winning something that you couldn't use or didn't want, when different organizations have raffles, they you put your ticket in the item, the carton for the item that you would want. And that's what they do here. So it's if you're not a spinner, you're not going to win fiber unless you put your tickets in a fiber bag, which is great because this way you can literally target what you want or what you would use. So at any rate, I had seen this and I was like, you know what? I'm going to just write down what it is. So as Laura was saying it, I'm like trying to get it into my phone and my daughter's going like doing one of these elbow things. You don't have to do that. And I'm like, yeah, I want it. She's like, you want it. So that was a treat. And I will show you the bag. So that's Wednesday night. Thursday and Friday are class days and you can take up to four classes if you're brave. I actually took three this year and it was great. It was really, I mean, I would have taken a fourth if I knew it wouldn't have pushed me over the exhaustion edge. But the classes you can choose, and Laura does literally, as I don't know how she works her magic, that people get the classes that they want, and it's really kind of hard to pick because the teachers are amazing. This year, I'm like looking down to see my tag, which I was wearing so many days. I know Lee Meredith, Ann Budd, Jillian Moreno, and I'm sorry, I don't know who the other teacher was because I didn't take a class with them. Gosh, I don't remember. But at any rate, the classes are wonderful. You get one class included with the retreat fee, and then if you want to take additional classes, they're $40 each. For the $40 I paid for the extra classes, I got a wealth of information that was unbelievable. And then Thursday night and Friday night, one night is the tasting room where, as I mentioned in the last video, they bring in, and I don't know, again, how these girls organize this and manage to get all this equipment, not only down there, but thought of to bring. It's unreal how they pull this off. I can't even imagine the effort. No, I can't imagine the effort, and I can only say that it is so greatly appreciated because it runs flawlessly, absolutely flawlessly. But at any rate, one night is the tasting room, and they bring, I don't know how to be over a dozen spinning wheels, different kinds, different styles. If you've ever wanted to try a wheel, and before you bought it or invested in it, that's the time. You can try out all of the wheels that are there. That's actually, I had tried, I guess it was Laura's line drum years ago and fell in love with it and resisted. And I recently got a new to me line drum and absolutely love it. So that's the, and the tasting room, they also have needles. And I talked about that in the last video. But you can try, if you've never had signature needles, and before you invest, and they are pricey, in them to see if they're for you. I mean, I can tell you, I push my needle, and I have drawn blood with my signature needles, which is why I'm going to show you the needles that I got, which are not quite as sharp, and I do love my signatures. I am not giving them up, but if you do push your needles and those, you find that the signature stilettos are too sharp for you, I may have an option for you. And then the following night, Friday night, is the Try It On Room, where you get tickets for bringing in things that you've knit, preferably garments, because, you know, shawls don't necessarily have to fit. And Leslie and Laura also bring down sweaters and hats and mitts and shawls and all different types of, it's, the room is packed with garments to try on. So if you look through the racks and they're done by size, and if you've ever thought of knitting, I can say, and I'm sure you've had the same experience when you go into a yarn store and you see the unknitted sample, you're like, gee, it didn't look that nice on Ravelry, or the picture. The pictures never do it justice when you look at it live. And this is just like going into a huge yarn bonanza of gorgeous garments that you now have to knit. And I will only say that if you get into SSK and you go into the Try It On Room, don't hold me responsible that when your queue has tripled in size, because it will. And then Saturday is the market where I did the damage. That is where my haul is from. They get vendors that are outstanding. Outstanding. And year to year, they bring back some old favorites, and every year they bring in new favorites. And this year's market was crazy. It was amazing. So that Saturday night is closing ceremonies, with the rest of all the door prizes are split between Wednesday and Saturday, and Sunday we have breakfast and go home. So let's talk about the market, because that is what we're here to talk about, the haul. I had shown there is a local yarn store called House of Yarn, and I bought two things there. I bought the yarn for the sweater that I showed in podcast A, in the first half of this podcast, which was Fiber Natura, and it was for the desk chain. I don't know how to say it, so it's all in there. I showed it and put it underneath. I don't want to butcher the name anymore. That was one thing that I bought. And the other thing was needles that I had tried on in the tasting room. I had tried these needles, and what they are, they're called Zing needles. And the ones that they had in the Try It On or in the tasting room, God, nothing like on my brain, were the Knit Pros, which are the English version from the UK. Our version is from Knitter's Pride. Actually, I said Knit Picks in my video. I have to correct that. It's Knitter's Pride. And this is the set of needles. And as you can see, the one is missing from the one that I'm working on. They go from size 2 to size 11. So it is a big set. And let me just take a bigger needle here so I can show it a little bit better. Here, this pink is light. They are very lightweight aluminum. They have a nice pointy tip, but not as pointy as the signatures. Now, I push my stitches, and I have drawn blood. And when you do it, like, right there, ow, it hurts. Now, I love my signatures. I will never give up my signatures. But these are, but they're pricey. They are expensive. I have collected them over the years. One by one. I never bought the set. It's just, it's crazy expensive. And even a set of needles is expensive. So this, to get the full set and the quality, from what I've seen, I have knit a bit with them. I think they're great. And they're under $100 for the set. For size 2, I believe. No, I'm sorry. I apologize. It's size 4 to 11. Size 4 to 11. And they're just smooth and they're pointy and they're just lightweight and absolutely awesome to knit with. So once I tried them in the tasting room, I had to get them. And then underneath, when you pull out the top of the needles, this was just, I mean, too much. It comes with two pairs of handmade wooden earrings. Where do you get knitting needles that come with handmade earrings? I mean, that is just too much. And I think these are called Melodies of Life is what these needles are called here, but they are Zing. And I believe somewhere on here it does say Zing needles. And it just says here about the earrings, Knitter's Pride now forays into the magical world of fashion jewelry with an eclectic collection that would be sold internationally under a new brand, Teakree. The collection, designed by a group of international designers around the enchanting colors of Knitter's Pride unique wood, would be launched next year. And they're including two pairs of these earrings, and apparently what it is it's made with the same wood that the wooden Knitter's Pride needles are made with. And they're asking for feedback, so they included two pairs, which I thought was nice. And they've also, you get this little pouch, and that has all of the necessary implements for interchangeable needles. You have your cords, you have end caps, you have, they gave you a bunch of stitch holders, and then there are extenders, so you can extend the cord. They are, it makes a 24-inch, there's two 32-inch and one 40-inch, and then if you use the connectors, you can pretty much make it as large as you need it to be. So that I found at House of Yarn. That was the only other thing other than the yarn that I purchased for my sweater that I can't pronounce. Okay. This was the door prize that I won. And I'll tell you why I thought this was just so awesome. And let me just see, because again, my daughter wouldn't let me write it down. It's starknits.etsy.com. And I will write that underneath. And to me, this was the ultimate spinning basket. It's nice and wide. This is a very smooth cotton on the inside. This is stiff. This is kind of stiff and sturdy, and it will stand upright and open. And I thought this would be a great idea because I usually, as I spin, my fiber is literally in the bag. And I'm undoing the braid and hang the bag off of my wheel. So it's womping back and forth, and it's sort of stuck in the bag. And this, to me, I thought would be absolutely great to put on the floor, or, you know, if you're going to be neat and not stick it on the floor like, you know, I do. You just put your fiber braid or your bat, whatever you're spinning from, into this basket, set it down, and then spin from that. So I just thought this was a wonderful idea. So this, like I said, was a door prize that I won, but just in case you would love to get one for yourself, this is starknits.etsy.com. That's, you can purchase these on Etsy. So I thank Starknits for this. I love it, and I will use it probably every day while I'm spinning. Moving along, the next thing I got was, this was a new vendor this year called Whimsy Stitches. What a lovely, lovely, lovely guy. He was just so nice. And I love these clear bags. Okay, yep, it's whimsystitches.etsy.com. Again, it's an Etsy shop. I will put everything here and link it below. So I got this project bag, which is like, I'm looking in here because I got something else from him. And it's a drawstring bag. It's clear. I saw the little hearts and the little chicks on it. And just, I mean, oh my gosh, down the rabbit hole. That was that. And it has a beautiful, really a nice handle that's clipped on here. and the ring. So if you have a carabiner that you put a tape measure on, anything like that, you can hang it off of here. So, or your stitch markers on your round ring, you can hang it off of here. So that was, I loved it. I like the style of the bag. And the other thing I purchased from him, I had not seen these anywhere. Okay. And I, again, after all those stitch markers, if you watched the previous episode, we'll call it episode A, the last thing on earth I need, besides any more yarn, is stitch markers. But that doesn't mean that you can't find something different. And I did. And this is my other passion. I found baseball themed stitch markers. Okay, so anybody who knows me, I'm trying to get the fourth one out of there and show it, but it's not cooperating with me at all. But at any rate, that's his website. You can see it on there, whimsystitches.com. And just he was just so nice. What a nice man. So that was one vendor, new vendor that was there, and I had to contribute. This actually I had pre-ordered, but she, I don't even know if she had some for sale there. I think she said she did, but very few. This is every year Amy Beth from the Fat Squirrel does an SSK bag, and on the bag she puts a wood, I believe it's called burnishing, I don't know what the technique is, but she puts Super Summer Knit together with the year and her name on there. And this year the fabric just blew me away. I mean, yeah. And if you're at all familiar with, and I have so many of them, and you can never have enough Amy Beth bags, she lines them with muslin. They are made exquisitely. They are perfect. The bottom is flat. If you kind of want it to be flat, it will sit open like that. And she even, the handles are just so beautifully made. I love them. I can never get enough. So I did pre-order this bag. So I guess technically it doesn't count as a haul. Okay, so because it was ordered before. But I did pick this up while I was down there. So we got that and added that to it. Now, this sort of is and isn't a haul item. Somebody down there, actually a few people, were knitting with these bags. And I asked them what they were and ordered it while I was down there. And it was here waiting for me when I came home. This is from Daisy Girl and Company. And I just thought that the fabric was so funny. I mean, Wake Me When the Kids Are Grown, TGIF, Thank God I'm Fabulous, All I Want Is Everything, Somebody Has to Be the Cutest. What else? Oh, this is what sold me. All the coffee beans in Colombia won't make me a morning person. Okay, that's what did it for me. And I love it because it's clear and it's so beautifully sewn. The polka dots on the inside, it's just a beautiful bag. It has the handle on the side. So I'm gonna say this wasn't a haul from there, it was enabled from there. How about that? We'll put it that way. Okay, now rest of the market haul. Oh, wait, yep, we've already had a casualty falling out, so we'll start with that. Okay. This was another new vendor. This was Hip Strings, Modern Fiber Arts. And I just wanted to just spend, the rest of the day like this because this is so soft. This is called Rose Quartz. It's 4 ounces and it's 75%. And she puts on all of her fibers the micron count. Which, if you're a spinner, it's really the fineness of the wool. And this is a 23 micron merino wool and 25% viscose from roses. From roses. So I'm going to see if I can get a decent shot of the colorways, but basically it's grays and pinks, different shades of pinks. There's some lavender in there, and this is as soft can be. Literally, it is so, so soft. So this is going to be interesting because this is what I was talking about, what we learned in the fractal. This is not a gradient. This is just sort of a randomly dyed braid. What I have learned to do, which I've never done before, is to open your braid completely and take a look at it. But I will likely spin this fractally into a 3-ply. Okay, so that's my intention with that. Will it happen? I don't know. We'll see. And while I'm doing that, I need the coffee. I had 2 episodes in one day. I think my body may go into shock. Oh, God, now I got fiber all over me. Okay. In your goodie bag, you get an option, a choice between yarn and fiber. This year I picked fiber. And it is from Into the World, which we all know I love her stuff. And the name of the colorway is called Tinkerbell's Unmentionables. And it is 100% Falkland. And these are the colors. And to me, it almost looks like the colors that we were spinning in class in the bat. So I have some really great, you know, ideas from having spun similar colorways in different ways on how I want to spin this, because I will not novel apply this. I will spin this a different way. So we're going to see, and I actually might even combine this with a different braid and see. So we're going to experiment with that. But that was the fiber that was included in your goodie bag if you chose the fiber option. Again, from the Hip Strings booth, this is actually, and I was kind of looking at it, I've never seen fiber come in this kind of box unless it was like batlings in there. So I was like, you know what? And she was like, no, it's a braid, but it's so fragile that we didn't want to hang it. We wanted it to get, you know, wherever, you know, home in one piece. And it is called Dark Magic. And again, the colorways were incredible. And I see sparkle, and well, down I went. Now this is 25% Tussa silk, 21% merino wool, 12.5% viscose, 12.5% mulberry silk, 12.5% faux cashmere, 12.5% baby camel, and 4% stellina. So you can only imagine how soft that this is. And obviously there's a lot of short staple, but the silk should give it good strength, because silk is a very strong fiber, whereas the camel and I don't know about faux cashmere. I know cashmere is a very fragile fiber and a very short stapled fiber, as is the camel. But combined with the two silks, I think this will spin up beautifully. So that was the other thing from Hip Strings. Her fibers were, oh my goodness. Then I went to Gail's Art. And having taken the class on combining different fibers and different braids and whatever, I found this. And this is a BFL Swirl Fiber Duo. So it's 8 ounces total. There is one multicolored braid with one matching 4-ounce solid. Now, if you're familiar with Gail's Art, Gail does some amazing, first of all, she's an absolute genius dyer. I took a class with her and have just an absolute new appreciation for fiber dyers, indie dyers. It is work. It is work, and it is knowledge. It is, you have to have color knowledge of the color wheel, how color works, how you see color. That is obviously, if you've seen some of my woo-woos, not my strong suit. So I leave it to the expert. And when I see two things combined in a bag that I don't have to think about, I'm all over it. So this is what I chose. This is the multicolor, and this is the solid. But Gail does a lot of her dyeing with leaves. In other words, she chooses a natural fiber and then dyes it, but it still shows the color, the original color of the fiber, which just, I'm crazy about that technique. I am absolutely crazy about that technique. So to have these two together is really, really, really amazing to me. It's very, very special. So that's what I got from Gail's art. Again, it's the BFL Swirl Fiber Duo, and I love spinning BFL, so that was a no-brainer. And I hit Lydian Color, Sarah, who is another just dying genius. I mean, she puts color together and she has such a great color sense. And I saw this and it just screamed fall to me. And it had sort of like a biker feel to it. And I don't know if I'm just getting old and getting crazy, or, well, we all know I kind of started out crazy, so maybe I'm just letting it go now. But I'm all about the biker thing. I mean, I just love it. I bought these glasses with motorcycle, with flames on. God knows, I'm probably having some midlife crisis. Who knows? But this color was screaming to me. It is called Sleepy Hollow. It is super wash fine merino wool. And in the last episode, when I was saying when you purchase a braid to know what you're purchasing, this is exactly what I'm talking about. This is not a gradient. This is kind of what I would say a speckled. So if I were to spin this my normal, usual way and Navajo ply it on itself, I would probably actually do this a disservice, because while it would keep the little bits together, there are not enough long to really show off the colors. So, but if you look at it and you open, and when I open up the braid and you take a look, you can then decide, do I want to blend the colors a lot? Do I want to blend the colors a little? So that should be a lot of fun. And I think I may do some sampling with this first. Let's tag on both sides so you really can just see the colors from here. I just saw the colorway, and like I said, my biker babe came out, and well, there it went. And then I went to Hobbledehoy. And I was so excited about this. One of the things I forgot to mention about SSK is that you get your one class included. You can take extra classes if you want. But one of the other things they do is that people volunteer. I did it 1 year on Knit Companion for what they call breakout sessions. And what it is somebody who either does something well or enjoys doing something and says, listen, you know, I'll teach a breakout in whatever. And they're sometimes some of the best parts, because 1 year someone taught tatting. People have done breakouts on supported spindling, on all different things. And I have a Turkish spindle. And Jerry Brock was one of the vendors. She also participated in SSK. She was one of the attendees as well. And she taught a breakout on how to use a Turkish spindle. And my biggest issue with it was winding on. For some reason, I was having, I don't know, I just couldn't get it. And thanks to her now, I can. And I'm going to show you, because I started, you'll see there's like a little space in here because I started one of these batlings. And I'll show you what it looks like so far. This is called Unicorn Batlings. These are organic Polworth wool, bamboo, silk, and sparkle. And it's a total of 2 ounces. And these are the unicorn colors. Okay, and the reason I really gravitated toward these is because, again, like I said, they're so easy. I don't know, I watch other podcasts. Nobody drops things and clangs things the way I do. It's a unique trait. There you go. Okay. So here you are. I started it on my Turkish spindle. which this one I purchased, I believe, last year or the year before at SSK. But I think you can see this time. Wait, let me just get that off. I don't think I crossed anything on the bottom. So I think I'm good. I think I got it wound on pretty good. And that's what the unicorn bat looks like. That's the singles. And I will show you in a few minutes how I intend to ply this. But the colors are just all pastels, and I loved it. I absolutely loved it. And I actually didn't realize there's a big hole in there because there's two batlings. I took an extra one out, and there's also a bunch of junk in this bag that has to come out. So that I got the unicorn batlings that I started spinning on my Turkish spindle, but it wasn't done because I also found these truffle hunt batlings. Now, I am all about pinks and purples and pastel-y colors. Love it. I would say, quote from the movie Steel Magnolias, pink is my signature color. We all know that. But when I see turquoise and brown put together, I lose my head because it's probably, as much as pink is my favorite color, that's probably my favorite combo. So I found these truffle hunt batlings, and yeah, I needed more batlings all of a sudden. So I think I read what was in there. So we'll just hold it up, and you can see some have more of the pink and the brown in it, and some have more of the turquoise and the brown in it. I will probably pick the pinkish ones and spin those onto hopefully one spindle, and the turquoisey ones onto another, and then put them together. But we'll see. So that was the next thing. I have feel a sneeze coming on from all of this fiber. I'm gonna try very hard not to sneeze. Then I visited, oh my God, this bag smells so good. Now we all know knit scents. I'm all about fragrance and scents. And Tufts Woolens, I have used her products before, and I cannot recommend them highly enough. I purchased her, this is the body bar, body and hand bar, hand and body bar. And I got this in the blueberry lemonade, which was exclusive fragrance for a previous SSK, but it was so popular, she did end up bringing it back, and I think it is permanent now in her repertoire. But this is a hand and lotion bar. What you do, it works almost like a lip balm. You raise it up, and it's like those solid lotion bars that you just sort of put it on and rub it your hands together. And oh, that blueberry lemonade. I mean, if you go to her site and get anything, jump down the blueberry lemonade because I stocked up when I thought she wasn't going to have it anymore. I think I bought her out of blueberry lemonade bars. And then she did. So I have a lot of that. And then I purchased two of her lip balms. We had gotten one in our 7-year kit that I ordered from the Knit Girls. And I had actually used her lip balms before, and I loved it. So this time I got fresh pear and coconut and espresso vanilla. And she had a special if you spent, I don't remember what it was, you got a little kit that came with the bag, and in there was the vanilla bean, which is the one we got with the 7-year kit from the Knit Girls, and I loved it. I've already been using that one. So again, if you're looking for a really good, and no, this is gonna fall, lip balm, I can't recommend that one highly enough. And then she went and did something that was just sent my bells flying. I had been looking for essential oils. Now, I use them in my diffusers, and I love them. But I had been looking for essential oils in a perfume, in a fragrance, because we know I'm all about the fragrance. If it's not yarn and fiber, it's fragrance. And they're hard to find because, I mean, they're not hard to find, but good ones are hard to find. And she came out with natural perfume oils from essential oils. Now, the first one I got, it's in a roll-on, is called Vanilla Almond. And she had, samples where you could try. She had maybe 4 or 5 different fragrances. So I got the vanilla almonds, but while I was at it, I had rolled on. She has one that's patchouli. And then I think it was patchouli and something else. There was something with honey, and I'm not a honey lover. But I had rolled the patchouli on. Patchouli can be funny. It can smell either really, really great, or it can just smell awful. So I said, all right, let me just, you know, try it. And I love the vanilla almonds, and I figured can't go wrong with that. And I went back to my room to put all of this stuff away, and I just kept, that patchouli was just unbelievable. So I went back, got the last roll-on of it from the counter, I love it. I actually keep it in my purse. So if you are looking for essential oils that actually smell like they're supposed to, try Tufts Woolens. I will again link her website. She has a lot of soaps. She has, I highly recommend all of her products. I believe she has some solid wool wash bars too on her website. So again, I will link that below. But that was my pickup at, so one of them is not here. I have another one of these again in the patchouli, but it went in my bag because it went in my bag because they wanted to do that. Okay, we're almost hitting the rock bottom here. Another new vendor, but nowhere new Dyer, because I have literally kicked myself every Sunday night when I miss her updates and was over the moon that she was vending at SSK was Lollipop Yarns. And if you've never tried Lollipop Yarns, her colors are vibrant and they stay vibrant. I have a pair of socks that I've knit out of her yarn that the color looks the same way it did in the skein before I even knit the socks. I don't know how she does it. I don't know. I can't even imagine. But I love her yarn. I do have some of it stashed, so I did only buy one skein, but I had to get it. This one is called Love Bug, and it's 6 rows of Huckleberry, 6 rows of Snuggle, 6 rows of Katydid, 6 rows of Snuggle Mini Me in Huckleberry. And one of the reasons why I chose this one, I loved it, is because it had the speckled yarn in the stripes, and I love when you have solid stripes and some of the stripes are speckled. And well, it was purple, and you know, that kind of made my mind up for me. So that was another, I'm just trying to see what, it's 80-20 merino nylon. Okay, and it's 410 yards plus 102 yards in the little heels and toes, because I'm assuming this ball is for heels and toes. Okay, we're getting near the bottom. The last booth I hit, I think, second to last booth I hit was, actually, yes, it was the last booth I hit, second to last. I always stop by Jelby. I will link her site. It is jelby.etsy.com. She is the one, if I'm sure you've seen it or seen someone that had it, she felts little round sheep. She makes felted tins. I love her stitch markers, but this time I think we got one of these in our goodie bag last year, and I went crazy for it. And this time I went back and got 2 more, mostly for the reason that one of them, I don't know what they call this little guy. If anyone knows the name, let me know. Just put it in the comments below. But he's just beyond adorable. What this is a stitch stopper. And what you do is, she said you pull this up first. Okay, so if you have thin needles, you pull it up a little more. If you have thicker needles, you pull it down a little more. And then you stick needles in here, and they're not going anywhere. So it basically works as a needle keeper, point protector, but one piece, with this beautiful little ceramic thing. And you can also use it, because she also added on a lobster claw, so it can also be a place marker. you know, or a removable stitch marker, whatever you want to use it as. So I got one with this little, I know there's a name for this character. What am I showing his butt in here? What am I doing? So if anybody knows what this who this character is, let me know, because I'd love to know. And the other one I got, oh gosh, good enough, get back on my page there. I saw she had a Mastroika, and I have a set of stitch markers in the Mastroika dolls, which I absolutely love, and it was pink. So, yeah, okay. Now, it's funny because once you've gone to SSK once or twice, you kind of get the drill of the market, and you go in with a plan. And what that plan is you kind of try to hit the booth with what you want the most, so that if it's, you know, gone, you gave it your best shot, as opposed to just sort of walking in and strolling, because people who have already been there know the strategy. Get what you know the list of vendors, some of them list a preview, so if there's something that you really, really have to have, go there first. And that's what I did. The first place that I went to was Acreworks. And the reason I did was because I wanted his Lazy Kate. And Laura had shown it. She has one on her on the Knit Girls podcast. And when I saw what it did, I had to get one. And Acreworks, the genius behind it is Aiden. And he designs these, and I'll show you. I did get some Acreworks bobbins, is really how this started. He does them on a 3D printer, and I will show you what the bobbins look like. But he showed me some ways to use this that I found were just amazing. Now, it comes with some pieces here, optional accessories. I don't know what they do. But you can purchase extra ones of these. And what these are, let me just explain why this Lazy Kate. First of all, it is you can travel with it. Now, I had to bring down a Lazy Kate for the classes, and I didn't want to bring the arch one from Shacht because I would have had to take it apart. I ended up bringing the one that came with my Lendrum, but it's still sticking up, and it's this one packs flat. Okay, so it makes a great travel tape. That's reason number one. These come up, and also all the kits that I have, I believe, are only three. You can do up to a 3-ply. This one actually, you can do up to a 4-ply. And these snap down, and there are 4 of these posts. Okay. Now, if you're going to use it as a standard kit, that's all well and good. You plop your bobbins on. And these things would go on top of your bobbin. Okay. Do not ask me how. Okay, I think they go on this way. And you slide this down, and it will tension your bobbin if you need tension on there. The farther you push down on the bobbin, the more tension you're going to have, the more drag you're going to have on the bobbin. Here's the thing. You can use this for spindles. Okay. If you take these and you put it on the post, you can put your spindle through here. And I don't know how to hold this so that I could show this, but imagine that these are pushed down. Okay, they're all the way down. You put your spindle through. I mean, I'm such a klutz, I just don't want to break this, but you can see it makes a little loop. You can stack your spindles, as many as you can fit on each of these posts. You can stack your spindles and ply from here. And what he showed me also, which somebody, one of his customers had shown him, is that if you're doing a supported spindle and you don't have enough room on the end, you only have the point of the spindle to work with, you can put the long end of the spindle through one of these, like this, and put the tip of the spindle into one of these cups and ply off of two spindles, two supported spindles. So this Lazy Kate has a lot of different ways to use it other than just your average Lazy Kate. I would probably use this one elevated. I know Laura had recommended that to me. I was having a little difficulty with the Lazy Kate that I had, and she suggested putting it on a chair. You can also, I've heard people say that if you tip it this way, your plying is better. I'd have to get back to you on that one and see if I can rig up a way to do that. I have no idea how to open this up. Oh, look at that. You just push on it. Just push on these little tabs and these fold down. The tabs come down, lock it into place, and you're off with your cape. So I just, that was the first place I ran. And I know he brought some unique woods, some different woods to SSK. I actually wasn't too picky, but when I looked at the woods, I was like, oh my gosh, they're like all so pretty. You know, like you want one of each, but you don't. So I got that. I'm trying to see if it says, I don't know. I believe it's birch wood, but I can't swear to that because I truly don't really remember which one. I was just so happy to get one of the capes that I was there and out the door. And then I got for my Lendrum. I thought I only had 3 bobbins. Turns out I had 5. Well, now I've got 8 bobbins for my Lendrum, which is good. These are the Acreworks bobbins. I'm sure from other podcasts you've seen them. These are really amazing, and I'm kind of sorry because I didn't have any of these for my Lendrum when I took it, and I really do prefer to travel with that wheel. I think I have the Sidekick, and while it does travel, I had a piece break on me at one point, and it was one of those pieces, I just dropped something else, that was an extremely difficult fix, and I ended up having to just use a wheel and fix it when I came home. And I'm a little leery to travel with that wheel right now anymore, but the Lendrum just traveled beautifully. But the Acreworks bobbins, he prints these in different patterns and in different colors on a 3D printer. And as you can see, they pack flat. So you can, even if there is fiber on here, you can take the ends off and they can pack flat as opposed to wooden bobbins, which, you know, they break, they get damaged. These are much sturdier. Let's see if I can actually put this on here. He makes these bobbins for all different wheels, but you need to get the one specific to your wheel. So if you have a Magicraft, there are bobbins for that. If you have a Shacked wheel, there are bobbins for that. These bobbins are specifically for the Lendrum. And you can see where the drive bands would go and where the brake band would go. And it's different on each of his bobbins, as each bobbin is different for all different wheels. But these are lightweight. They come in different colors. I will try spinning on this before the next episode. I don't know if I have anything. I have, I think, one of his bobbins for my Shacked wheels. And the Shacked wheels are all interchangeable, so you can use them on any of the Shacked, except for the Saxony, the Shacked Reeves. That calls for a different bobbin. But one of the beauties is that you can look through the side of the bobbin and actually see what you're spinning, whereas on a wooden or even a travel bobbin, you can't do that. That's it. I think that's it. So, I mean, I was kind of naughty, but could have been a lot worse. I just want to show you, every year the girls give you, when you go, as you enter the market, and you can, if you live in the area, you can attend the market. I think it's $5 and you get entry to the market. It's in the afternoon after the, SSK attendees have done, but the vendors do hold back, so you do get an opportunity to purchase the same things that the attendees did. But this year's market bag, I think the girls, I don't know how they keep outdoing themselves. It was this nylon bag with their logo for this year on there, which I loved. It's this just lightweight, great bag. But I said to Leslie, I'm like, what's this for? The goodies that you forgot? I don't know. I'm like, I wasn't thinking. I was overloaded on yarn fumes. I'm like, oh, is this for extra goodies that you forgot when you go back in the market? And she's like, no, the whole bag folds up into this little bag. So I'm like, well, now you know what I'm going to Rhinebeck and Maryland Sheep and Wool with. This is going to be my extra overflow bag. So I just thought that was really, really cute. I mean, they always, like I said, give just 110%. So that is it. That is all. That is my SSK haul. Hopefully I will have at least one, if not both of these videos up at some time in the near future. Thanks to all the phone calls, I'm going to have to do a lot of editing on the first one. But it was fun. We had a fabulous time. I am looking forward to learning with all of this fiber, really experimenting with it, giving it a good, trying to apply some of the techniques that I learned. And I hope you will join me in my adventures and my experiments with all of this stuff. And again, if you did not watch or saw this, caught this first, check out episode 23A, which I will likely call SSK Recap. This one I will call literally label haul video. There is a contest that I will be opening up in that episode. So be sure to have a look. And I will see you all soon. And until then, always knit with sense.